Okay, so in this video we are going to see the execution of second program in the first experiment of microcontroller laboratory, that is write an assembly language program to transfer n by 5 bytes of data within two external memory 1000H and 2000H without any overlap. Okay, so in the earlier code 1.1 we had seen the data transfer within internal memory. So this code is an example for data transfer within two external memory locations. Okay, so this is data. Okay, so I got my data here. Okay, so after writing the source code, you have to save the source code as file name .asm. In my case, it is sample.asm. Okay, save the file and make sure that you add the source code to the project. So after writing the source code, you have to check for the syntax error. That is, right click on the source group, build target, or F7 is the shortcut key. Okay, fine. So once the error is zero, go to the next step, that is debug start session. Okay, now so we have to enter the data in the external memory starting at location 1000. Okay, so how to specify the external memory? To specify the external memory, the code is x for external memory colon 0x. That is, so that indicates hexadecimal number system 1000. Okay, so that is the external memory location. Okay, fine. Now we'll take the destination location also, so that we can parallelly view the data transfer. Okay, so now first we have to enter the data in the source location. Right click on the first location, modify memory at this location. Starting from that location, enter 5 bytes of data. Let us say separated by comma. Let us say my data is 8, 10, comma 54, 63. You can take any random set of data, 5 bytes of data. Okay, fine. Now, 5 bytes of data is stored in 1000 location. Okay, and at 2000 location, 0, because I made to transfer the data, execute the code. Okay, fine. Now, let us run the code, debug go. And you can see that the data is now copied into the destination location starting from the source location. Okay, so that's how in this program we have understood how to transfer the data within two external memory location. Okay, fine. Now let us say, for example, let us say what in case if the given data is more than 5 bytes of data, more than 5 bytes. Okay, so let us observe that. So first step is, let me stop the code. Okay, yeah, so build target, debug start session. Let us say my data is more than 5 bytes. Okay, so let us say I'll give let us say 4, okay, 6 bytes of data. Okay, so for example, I've given 6 bytes of data. Okay, at the source location, debug run. Okay, at the destination location, you can see that only 5 bytes of data are transferred. The 6th byte is not transferred because the code runs only for 5 bytes, which is being controlled by the control variable. In our case, it is register R5. So R5 will control the number of bytes to be transferred from source location to destination location involving external memory.